body free, I guess, is the basic building block for some standard of sanitation in every city. It's fortunately, unfortunately, Indian cities are now getting up to that and getting this certified. Pune was certified open OD free in January 2017. This process consists of three dimensions. One, what does OD free mean? It means that every household where there is a feasibility of space should have a household toilet. Two, every household who doesn't have the feasibility of setting up a toilet in their own house should have an access to one of the toilets. It generally are community toilets in and around 500 meters. And three, there should be a toilet access within 1 kilometer of every major public community space. So this is the definition of OD, right?
Okay.
And how is it certified? You, as a city, you. So what we have done is the first thing we wanted to do and done is do a gap analysis as to what is the baseline, what is that, or where is that we need to build some of these toilets. So on entire city basis, Pune Corporation have done a survey. It's a house to house survey, and we've evolved a gap of 43,000 households plus with the feasibility to set up a household toilet. We've done a little process innovation. One, because central government is contributing 4,000, state was contributing 6,000, we were contributing 8,000. So we could tweak the process a little bit to make a contract, and we are making a household sign on that, which says that, dude, you don't worry, you are gonna hand over your right to build a toilet to the city. So we've empaneled the builders and the mason. Through which we got economies of scale, and we have put these service level agreements and the standards which has to be uniformly followed, and to put this to protect the integrity of this very big program, we've co-opted NGOs like Shelter, Samagra, and we appointed an independent third party audit to audit all these facilities and certify that these are well and good, ready to use.
Right.
And the third aspect which kicks in is the audit by the central government, the government of India. There is an organization called Quality Council of India, the team which comes from Delhi, see whether your paperwork is in order, see some of the facilities you built, and they do random sampling of physical checkup of OD practice in the city, and then is when the certification happens.
Okay.
So yeah, this is the process, and we're glad that we came through, and this has to be renewed every 6 months. So as not to let the city authorities lose focus on this very important component.
Right.
So since then we've been running a certification.
Okay, definitely Pune has all the infrastructure in mind because I know it's
implemented. Right. See, I think for all the audience here, when I say the city is OD free, it doesn't mean that 100% of the population have access to toilet and use the toilet. Right.
Yeah.
Access to toilet.
Yeah.
So access is one which will get us an OD free, but there is a very big component of IEC which we call information education and communication to induce behavioral change on the general population to change their behaviors in accessing the sanitation infrastructure. So our next target right now is OD plus, which says your 80% of population of the city should have an access to individual household toilet. But yeah, that would be a work in progress because primarily we are working on IEC, and we are working on something called a smart sanitation project for the city. This is because traditionally the way we address sanitation is generally you look at it as a cost to the city. You traditionally there is an annual budget, you ask for, you get the budgets, and you put, we wanted to bring a little structure and analysis to this entire process of devolution of funds and building your assets. So right now I have a lot of community toilets, a lot of public toilets for which I have no data on to see whether they're good, what is the feedback, and how should I allocate my resources to some of these projects. To some of these resources. So we have partnered with an NGO called TBC, which is Toilet Board Coalition of Switzerland. They're working with us to generate data on the sanitation infrastructure assets of the city. right? As a part of Smart Cities mission, we are setting up something called Integrated Command Control Center. We want data to flow from every one of our sanitation assets back to the Command Control Center, which will aid as a major decision-making tool. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So that would help us actually understand what is the usage statistics, what is the feedback, and how should I allocate my resources in I'll reallocate some of them in taking away some of the existing things, so on and so forth. We are in the process of bringing a structure and analysis to this entire process of funding this part of the thing. Mm-hmm. And as I said, next target is ODF within the next 18 months is what we are looking at. ODF plus, which is 80% of the people. Again, when you see, it's not a sanitation vertical planning. So if there are concentrated slums in the city, and if there is no space right now, and if I'm saying in 18 months time, I'm going to build a toilet for them, where is the space coming from? So it has to co-work with some of the other Government of India programs, such as slum redevelopment program. So we are relocating all these people to 1 BHK houses where there is a provision of toilet. That is how we're going to progress from ODF to ODF plus. So you should never see something as a vertical thing. It's always horizontal.